morning. Welcome to CATEX TV. My name is Frank Fortunato. Today is Wednesday, March 28th, 2012. Lloyd's of London has come out with their numbers for 2011, and as expected, they sustained a loss. They sustained a loss of about 516 million pounds, or $822 million US. They saw their combined ratio creep all the way up to 106.8%. In 2010, it had been 93%. Actually, though, the Lloyd's loss, given the scale of what happened in 2011, with $116 billion of natural catastrophes, was not so bad. Richard Ward and Tom Bolt and company deserve commendation. Swiss Re had raised its industry loss forecast for the Thai flooding all the way up now to $12 billion, making the Thai floods the highest ever total flood event in history. This is $12 billion. This is something that came out of left field. The initial market estimates were $2 and $3 billion or so back when the flooding began. Swiss Re also estimated a record $49 billion industry-wide of earthquake losses for 2011. This would be $35 billion stemming from the Japanese quake and $12 billion coming from the February 22nd, the second Christchurch earthquake in New Zealand. More Solvency II disruption in Europe. Gotha Re, a $5 billion premium a year German mutual insurer, has announced that they've given up their intention of creating their own internal risk model as required under Solvency II, and is in fact using the standard risk model. Solvency II encourages insurers to use an internal risk model that needs to be approved by regulators in order for it to then better particularly match its own assets and risk tastes. Gotha decided that it was impossible to get such a vehicle approved and decided to go ahead and use the standard vehicle itself. The Gotha CEO has been a longtime critic of Solvency II. The market is holding its breath over what may be going on in the North Sea. That would be that Elgin platform that has been completely evacuated now since Sunday. The platform is insured for about $2 billion. It's a joint venture with Chevron and BG Group, even though Total SA, the French oil company, in fact, is currently leasing it. Total said that a flare is still burning on the offshore platform. They said that there is no threat of explosion at the moment, but that they're monitoring the situation carefully. They said for now the wind is blowing in a direction that does not pose a risk to the rig. Surveillance flights have detected a sheen around the platform. There's a big wildfire outside of Denver, Colorado, and federal fire crews have taken the responsibility for fighting the fire away from the state. They're there now. This is a 7-square-mile blaze. It's killed at least 2 people, damaged 28 homes. It's located in the mountains just southwest of Denver, Colorado. Now, here's something that might be of interest. If you're looking for a place to put your money, Bermuda insurer Maiden Holdings yesterday announced that it sold $100 million of 30-year notes. The interest rate was 8%. The notes were fully subscribed. You may scratch your heads going, my goodness, why is somebody selling notes at 8%? Well, the proceeds from the notes are going to be used to retire the company's debt on an outstanding 14% note that they issued in 2009 for working capital. Well, that's a pretty good deal. That's the news for today. If we have any breaking news, we'll come back and tell you. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you tomorrow.